accident, but I ended up getting a puncture, and just, I thought, I've had the commuter bike for a while, and I've wanted some lighter, faster wheels for the bikes. So I took the opportunity after the accident to treat myself and try and upgrade the bike. So I got some tires with a bit more grip and decided to get some wheels while I was at it. So this is that unboxing today. That may go on to a fitting as well. We'll see. I'm not sure. Maybe the front wheel, maybe the back wheel too. I need to remove the cassette, I guess, sprockets from the rear wheel with a tool, which I haven't done before. Hopefully, it's not too complicated, but as I've never done it before, it may turn out to be more complicated than I expect. So, we'll just start here, keep going, and see where we end up. Invoice for the wheels. They are, so you know, they are from Superstar Components, as you might be able to read on the box. They sell directly from their own site. They don't appear to be on any other sites. And the wheels are PAVE 28 Ultra 11 speed wheel set. 20 by 24, so I think 20 is the front wheel because it's got 20 spokes, and 24 is the rear wheel because it has 24 spokes. So there are two wheels, and they come with Zeal Zeal upgrade black hubs, which I don't really know anything about them. I don't know a lot about commuter bikes. There's a really handy website called road.cc, and it's a road bicycle site. They do stuff about like cyclocross bikes as well, but it's mainly like road bikes and commuter bikes and stuff like that, racing bikes. And they have like buyer's guides and things like that. And in their wheels buyer's guide, they said that this is the only set of wheels they've ever reviewed that were under £200 that they gave a 4.5 star rating to. So I was it under 200? Under 300. Under 300, which honestly is really cheap for wheels, for good wheels. So they said because they were so well made when they were made by hand and put together, it really translates into quality while riding, and they couldn't fault them really, so they got a really high rating, and they were within my budget. You know, there were other wheels that were in the list that were like £2,300 and £4,000 and stuff, which that's way out of my budget, but these are expensive for me. It's kind of a lot of money, but it's within budget, and if the wheels are as good as they say, then I feel like it would be worth it. So let's take them out. first thing that I noticed about the wheels when I took them out of the box is how tight the spokes are. My bike is behind the camera and I just gave them a squeeze and the spokes are they're still quite tight on my bicycle, but the spokes on these wheels are really stiff, which is good. Which has a kind of clicky cassette. My current wheel on my bicycle doesn't really have a loud clicky cassette hub. It's got this little rubber band on it, which is holding a shim here in place, which I assume is for when you put a 9-speed set of cogs on, which mine is a 10-speed, so I think I'll probably be taking that shim off. I'll have to see when it comes to the fitting stage. They don't appear to have any rim tape, so I'll need to check the box to see if the rim tape's in the box. Interestingly, there's no rim tape in the box. Looking at the machined holes where you can gain access to the spokes are quite deep, so I don't know if because of the rim design with the deep wall here that they don't need rim tape. I'm not sure. I'll just transfer the rim tape from my current real wheels into these wheels. So I'll start with the front wheel, simply because it's going to be a lot less complicated to remove that wheel and do the fitting. by using these spoke tools. Sorry, these kind of tire removing tools. This while the wheel was still on the bike frame, but it's easier to film this way. So the front wheel is off. I'm just going to do a little weight comparison whilst holding them. So the new wheel versus the old wheel. The new wheel is definitely lighter. Doesn't have the axle in it yet, which I'll transfer from this wheel to this. I just wanted to get it on to make sure that it fit. I'm not an expert on these kind of bikes, so I assumed that it was the right wheel, but kind of impulsively bought without checking enough. But it seems like it's okay. I'm not sure how the rim tape works. I'm gonna try and peel it off and then just hope I can transfer it without an issue. Okay, so I have the rim tape on the wheel now. Don't know if you can see that. The white is the rim tape. So it's time to try and fit the inner tube and the tire. Okay. I'm by no means a like pro bike person, so if anybody knows a much easier way to put tires onto these style of bikes, then well, it'll probably be too late to let me know by the time this video gets published, but feel free to let me know anyway for future. That if I put a little bit of air into the inner tube first, I find it easier to manipulate the tire onto the rim. all over the place like a blue-ass fly. Step two. So that's step two. You can see it wasn't this difficult for me the first time around. I think where the tire's been on the bike and it's been inflated, the tire is. So yeah, fitting the tire is a slightly different experience after the tire's been on the bike and inflated from when I took it out of the box new, and standing up and trying to do it is really awkward and unnatural, but I'm getting there. We're almost there. So I just had a bit of a an ew gross moment with my hand where I my nails kind of I used them to leverage the bead of the tire over into the frame, but they kind of got squashed between the rim and the tire for a second. It was a bit like nails on a chalkboard. So the wheel is now in position. The brakes are not aligned to the rim very well, so I'll need to make adjustments to the brakes so that they clamp onto the surface evenly and in the correct position. But that is one of two wheels done, so I kind of really wish that I left the camera rolling just now, because I fixed the brakes and it was actually so straight. as you tighten it up, this silver barrel here adjusts how much both of them clamp in overall. So you get a screwdriver here, and you adjust this one and this one, and you close the pads until they're an equal distance apart from the brake wall, and clamp at the same time. It's super simple, actually. I was really pleasantly surprised. One other thing that I do have to do is this pad's a little bit low, so I want to lift it up a little bit. It's kind of a bit far down, so I'm going to use my hex wrench or Allen keys and do it. Lift it up, tighten it again. This is the size that I'll need. That's it, done. That was so straightforward compared to the BMX brakes. Nice. I mean, it's no disc brake, but it'll still do nicely. In future, I would like to upgrade these Sora brakes to some Altegra brakes. They're kind of like the best rim brakes that you can get, considering no one really bothers making rim brakes anymore. It's all disc brakes now and hydraulic disc brakes, but you need special frame mounts for disc brakes, which I don't have, so I can't put, I can't get, there's no point, because I can't have disc brakes, unless I buy brand new frame and forks, which I'm not gonna do. So I think there might be enough time to try and repeat the process with the rear wheel, or maybe we won't bother with the inner tube and stuff, because you've seen that already, so maybe this time I'll just try and take off the cassette and change it over. It'll be a new experience for you and for me. I'll adjust the camera so that it's facing more over the sheet, because this is going to be a very oily job. So I'll unlock the wheel and kind of get it out of the frame to begin with. have any disposable hand wipes, but I've got some computer monitor wipes that I think they're antibacterial as well, so. Changed the position of the camera so I can sit down and work. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to need for this. Sure, I need this. I should probably look up how to do this. Be right back. Okay. So I need the chain whip. Was pretty scary, like, because I was like convinced I was gonna break it or something. I'm gonna give everything a clean and a grease because while I have it off, I might as well. Thank you. myself any more work to do, but fuck it. That's not my style. My loop. Bicycle loop. So here's the nice new wheel. wash my hands about 10 times after this. Thank you. Okay, so all the cogs are on and greased up. There was a little spacer that came with it, so I went online to check whether I should put the spacer on for this hub and for this cassette on this wheel. And apparently, yeah, they should. The spacer should be put on, so it's on, and I'll tighten it up now. Feels decently tight. Okay, so I'll fit the inner tubes and the tires like you saw me do already, and then I'll come back for a little wrap-up and goodbye. Okay, so the new wheel is on, the hub's on, the tires on and all pumped up and everything. I'm just gonna take a look at the brakes now and make sure they are centered the way that the front ones are. They look like they could do with a little bit of adjustment, but I'll just check and see because I haven't checked properly yet. Yeah, I could do with a little bit more space on this side, so. Hub's a lot louder than my old one. Which I don't mind too much. Adjust the screw on the far side, which will adjust this arm's distance from the rim wall. so the brake pads look equidistant. So the brake pads are equidistant from the rim wall, and as the wheel turns, it doesn't rub or get too close to either of the brake pads and the brake pull on the lever. So the pull on the rear brake and the front brake are pretty even, so this requires the same amount of force to brake each one. So that's it, that's the new wheels on, the new tires on. I took the cassette off for the first time, which I've never done before, gave it a clean, re-greased it, refitted it. Shot of the bike. For anyone who's interested, there's a limited amount of space in this room, and it's the only room I can really do it in. I'll try and get a quick shot of the bike framed before I sign off. So yeah, this is kind of the best I can do on in a rush. I haven't had dinner yet, and I need to kind of clean up, have some food before I go to bed tonight. But that's it. That's the bike. The bike. If you're interested and want to know what it is, if you don't already, it's a B-twin, 520. The 540 is actually quite a bit nicer. It comes with disc brakes and stuff, but it's like £550 or £600. This, the B-twin 520, used to be 350 new, so probably a lot less than that. And I got this one secondhand for 300, and it was in mint condition. The guy had ridden it like 3 or 4 times and had to sell it because he was having another baby and needed the money. So I managed to get the bike. It was basically brand new for £50 off. I've made some mods to it, but it's a great bike off the shop floor. I've got triple shifter 105 levers. I didn't really like the Sora levers, the Shimano Sora levers that came on it, so I upgraded to some 105 Shimano levers that have kind of like a high rise on the top, so you can rest your hand on the tops of the shift nicer too. The levers are also longer, so it makes it easier to shift and brake when you're using the drops on the bars. I upgraded the front rings, the two large rings, to 105 from Sora, just because the Sora ones got damaged, the teeth got warped, so I switched them for 105, so they were basically exactly the same rings, but silver instead of black. The rear cassette that you saw me take apart and grease and put back together is a 10-speed Altegra. So it used to have a 9-speed Sora, now it's got a 10-speed Altegra. I changed the front and rear derailleurs for Sora, from Sora to Altegra. So it's got Altegra derailleurs and rear cassette and 105 front rings. The cranks are the same, the cranks are still Sora. It's got these giant shit pedals on it. I just don't like pedals with kind of holsters, and I don't use SPDs or clip-ons because I don't want to clip my feet in. I don't care for it. I don't want to carry a second pair of shoes around with me either. I don't need to go fast that badly. The brakes are Shimano Sora brakes, but I might be getting Altegra rim brakes for Christmas, maybe. They've got Continental Grand Prix 4000S Mark II tires on. They're new because I got a puncture, and they come with Hutchinson folder Kevlar bead folding tires, which are really nice tires. They come on a stock bike, so they came with Hutchinson tires, which were really nice ones, but they got a bunch of glass stabbed through them, so I needed new tires. And the wheels that you saw me put on today, they are the Pave, the Superstar Components Pave 28s. The seat is stock, it came on the bike. I wouldn't mind a new seat at some point. Maybe a carbon fiber seat post or something to reduce the weight, but I mean, I don't mind the weight of the bike. I think it's already quite light. And yeah, and I think it's got a Shimano 10-speed chain, or triple shifter chain, no, 10-speed chain, because it's a thinner chain than a 9-speed chain or something like that. Yeah, and that's it.